when you have a metabolic switch from burning glucose for fuel to burning ketones for fuel as the primary fuel in the brain, that the brain's metabolic machinery runs more efficiently, and also the balance of the neurotransmitters are such that you have more GABA versus glutamate ratio in the brain. So GABA is a neurotransmitter that has a brain stabilizing effect, whereas glutamate can, if it's in excess, can cause hyperexcitability and can contribute to the etiology of a seizure. So it's actually increasing the balance of inhibitory to excitatory neurotransmitters in the brain. So this is another area of investigation with our work with the ketogenic diet. Its metabolic effects, which are numerous, and that it supplies the brain with the energetic precursors to maintain its ATP levels, energy currency, and it also impacts the neuropharmacology of the brain by increasing, for example, Krebs cycle intermediates, also called TCA cycle intermediates. These intermediates become the precursors for neurotransmitters, so it actually helps to boost neurotransmitter levels in the brain, and it helps to shuttle glutamate. Glutamate's an excitatory neurotransmitter, and your body needs glutamate to make GABA, and it does that through an enzyme called glutamic acid decarboxylase. And the ketogenic diet, or being in a state of ketosis, causes a transition of more excitatory amino acids to inhibitory through the activation of this enzyme. So if there's more this brain stabilizing effect through more GABA reduces the energetic demands on the brain, and by reducing the energetic demands, there's less oxygen free radicals that are being produced. Because remember, oxygen free radicals are a consequence of really two things: the level of oxygen in the brain, but also the extreme metabolic demands that are put on the brain.